Okay, hey YouTube, this is Gloria. My name is Gloria, and this is the third time I do this video, and I am getting tired of doing this video over and over again because this stupid camera thingy that I'm using, my laptop, it's not working so good. So I'm so sorry. Well, a lot of people have been requesting me to do videos and stuff like that about my journey and me trying to my miscarriage and everything that I went through. So here I go. I'm gonna try to do this in pieces and as fast as I can because I did the other videos really long and they ended up deleting and it's getting me frustrated. So here I go. First of all, I want to say that for all you mothers that have had a miscarriage, I am so sorry. I know how hard it is, and I know how it feels to lose a baby, and to go through that, it's really hard. Well, I started really fast. I want to say that I started bleeding one day when I was in Target, and I went to the restroom, and I realized that I had brown spotting. It was really, really, really little bit, but it was there, you know. And now I know that any woman that's pregnant who is spotting it, any, I don't care what the doctors tell you, it's not normal. Okay, for me, my OBG told me that it was normal for pregnant women to bleed because most women bleed and they don't go through nothing. But I mean, most of the time it's not true, you know. Don't fall for that. It's not true. It's not normal to bleed, you know. It's just not normal to bleed. It's awful. Once you start bleeding, the things that you start going through, it's hard. So once I started bleeding, that same day I had pains too. So I went to my I told my husband just because I had pains on my thighs, and I told my husband that I saw a little brown. I told him what happened, you know, that I saw brown in my liner. I was wearing a liner then, and that I was feeling a little pain, so maybe we should go home because I was kind of tired already. So we went home, we were shopping for almost the whole entire day, so we decided to just go home, and so we did. After I got home, I told my aunt what had happened, and she told me that it was not normal for a pregnant woman to bleed, especially so early on the pregnancy, and also that it wasn't normal to feel pains in my waist and my thighs, you know. So I decided, they kind of forced me to go to the hospital, but now that I think about it, well, I'm glad that I went, but at the same time, you know, it is expensive. But yeah, I went to the hospital, and they gave me all the, after so long, whatever, they did me a blood test. I found out that I was actually 4 weeks pregnant, I mean 3 weeks pregnant, and not 4 weeks how I thought I was. But can you lock it? Mm-hmm. But everything was fine, I guess. They just gave me a paper with saying that it was that I might be having a possible early miscarriage, which I never thought I was gonna be able, which I never thought I was actually gonna go through. After that, they recommended me to go to my OBG, which I did, and my OBG, he was actually a guy, you guys. And I know that most girls don't like to have guys OBGs just because you feel uncomfortable. But let me tell you something. I thought I was gonna feel uncomfortable, and when I first met him, Dr. Salazar was awesome. He was he made me feel so comfortable and made my husband feel comfortable too. And he actually helped me in every stupid question that I had, every little stupid question that I had, you know, he actually helped me. But probably the only thing that I have to say about him right now is that, no, Dr. Salazar, it's not normal for a pregnant woman to bleed, you know. It's not. It's not. It's just not. So I went to, so he checked my baby, and he told me that it was that my heartbeat was there, that he was looking good so far, you know, that it's normal for pregnant women to bleed, so, you know, to relax and stuff like that. I was like, okay, fine, and I'll relax. So a month later, just to shorten up the story, it was longer, but just to do this, because I don't want this stupid camera to, like, to delete my message again. My blog again, and I'll get super angry. About a month later, I was like about almost 8 weeks, but not quite there yet, maybe 7 weeks. I noticed that, okay, me and my husband had sex, of course, and I started bleeding after sex, and for me, I don't think it's normal, you know, bleeding after sex. So I went to the hospital, and they told me that they did me like blood tests and check my progesterone or something like that, and I had no idea what all of that meant, but everything was fine. So I went to my OBG the next day, called, and he told me that, like he had said, you know, bleeding is normal, but he did recommend me to stop having sex for 3 months, just because, just so I wouldn't get scared if I saw blood again. He wanted me to relax, so he told me to stop having sex. But like I said in my previous videos, as you guys know, if you guys are married or if you guys have boyfriends or whatever, you guys know that for a guy to stop having sex for 3 months, that's a lot. That's hard, you know. He did tell me that there's other things that you could do other than sex, but come on, I don't. There's just things that I won't do, you know. I don't know. It's fine. I'm not criticizing people that do, but not me, you know. So after that. Sorry, guys. Yeah. After that, to make the story short, I went to the, we went home, a month passed, and now we are, not a month, but a few days, a few weeks passed, and now we were 8 weeks, 2 months, and we had sex, which is, because the doctor said that we could have sex, but he recommends us not to have sex, just because he knew that if I saw blood, I was going to get scared, you know? We were going to be scared and freak out and stuff like that. So he said, just don't have it, but if you guys do, you know, just keep in mind that you guys are going to probably see blood. But this time, it was more blood than the first time, you know? This time, after we had sex, it was a lot of blood, you know, and I got scared. I had to literally get a towel and clean myself because it was so much blood. I don't know, it was just a lot of blood. It's 8, okay, as soon as it hits 10, I'm up to the other video, stop it and do the other video. But, it was a lot of blood, you guys, and so we continue on, and, well, not to have sex, but we fell asleep afterwards. I took a shower and fell asleep. And when I got, it was like around 2 a.m, and I had the urges to go pee. I woke up because I had to go pee really bad. So I went to pee, and as soon as I got up, I felt something warm coming down through my legs, and it was blood, and I got scared. I mean, really scared. It's really scary to go through that. It just, like, it was blood. Let me stop this video just so I could do